Hello friends, today we are going to study about HDLC. First of all, let us know why we are studying HDLC. Basically, radar signal processor needs to receive control instructions from control computer during processing data and then transmit processing results back to the control computer. This handshake process requires appropriate communication standards and protocols to achieve. HDLC is one of the protocols which is widely used in communications. Next, let us see which topics are going to be covered in the topic. First of all, we'll see the definition of HDLC, then framing, HDLC station and configuration, transfer modes, HDLC operation and frame types, and lastly, HDLC control bits. First, let's see what is HDLC. HDLC is a bit-oriented HDLC is a bit oriented HDLC basically stands for high level data link control. It is bit oriented protocol. It was developed by International Organization for Standardization, that is ISO. There are basically four standards which was originally framed by ISO, which are ISO 3309, ISO 4335, ISO 6159 and ISO 6256. The current standard for HDLC, which is named here, that is 2002, which it replaces all of the above standards. Now let's see what are framing in HDLC. There are basically two types of framing, that is synchronous and asynchronous. Mostly synchronous type of framing is used in HDLC. Now let us study about HDLC station and configuration. There are three primary stations. There are three basic stations, which are primary, secondary, and combined station. The primary station is the most important station, which is used for controlling the station on the link. It has the responsibility of controlling all the other stations, and it is usually responsible for organization of data flow on the link. It also takes care of error recovery at the data link level. The secondary station is under the control of primary station. It has no ability of its own and it has no control over the link. It is only activated when the primary station wants to activate it. And it can only send response frames when requested by the primary station. That is, it is completely dependent on the primary station. Third, the combined station is a combination of primary and secondary, and it cannot perform any function without the permission of primary and secondary stations. Then there are three configurations under which HDLC is defined. It is unbalanced configuration, balanced and symmetrical. The unbalanced configuration consists of primary station and one or more secondary stations. The unbalance occurs because one station controls the other station. In balanced configuration, HDLC link consists of two or more combined stations. Each of the stations has equal and complementary responsibility compared to each other. Hence, the situation is balanced in this configuration. In symmetrical configuration, two independent point-to-point unbalanced station configurations are there. In this configuration, each station has primary and secondary station status. Each station is logically considered as two stations. Now let's see the transfer modes, which are normal. There are three types of normal response mode as seen in the previous slide. So normal response mode, this is the primary station. This is where the primary station initiates transfers to the secondary station, and the secondary station can only transmit a response when and only when it is instructed to do so by the primary station. The primary station has two types, that is point to point primary response mode and multipoint. In point to point, a command is given from primary to secondary, and only one user can be receiving the command at a time, and the response from secondary travels back to the primary. In multipoint, the primary can send commands to various users at a time, and the responses can be received back by the primary simultaneously from both the PCs or both the users. Next, we study about asynchronous response mode. It is the primary station doesn't initiate transfers to the secondary station. In fact, the secondary station does not have to wait to receive explicit permission from primary station to transfer any frames. The frames may be more than just acknowledgement frames. In asynchronous balanced mode, this mode uses combined stations. There is no need for permission on the part of any station in this mode. This is because combined stations do not require any sort of instructions to perform any task on the link. Now, let us know there are some non-operational modes in HDLC. There are three non-operational modes, which are normal disconnected, asynchronous disconnected, and the initialization mode. The two disconnected nodes differ from operational modes in that the secondary station is logically disconnected from the link. In the IM mode is different from operations mode is that the control program is in need of regeneration. Now there are some frames which we need to study about HDLC. There are three basic types of HDLC frames, which are information frames, supervisory frames, and unnumbered frames. The basic structure of all the three frames are as shown in the figure. As we can see from the diagram, in iframe, it uses flags, address, control, user information, FCS, which is FCS flag, which we'll be studying in the next slide. In SRAM, there is no user information. It only contains the address and control and the FCS of the stream. In UFRAME, there is address, control, and management information and FCS. There is no user information in UFRAME. You just need to send the management of the data. Next, there are the typical fields about how much data each bit can store. It is given as follows. The flag field is of 8 bits. The address field is of 8 bits. Control field is also, control bit can be for 8 or 16 bits. Information field, which is not used in some frames. Frame check sequence, that is the FPS as we told before. It is 16 or 32 bits. And the closing flag field, it is of 8 bits. Next, we see about the HDLC control bit. HDLC uses the control field to determine how to control the communication process. This contains commands, responses, sequence number, which are used to maintain the data flow and accountability of the link. There are three control field formats: information transfer format, supervisory format, and the unnumbered format. There are basically two types of control fields, 16-bit and 8-bit. The 8-bit figure is as shown. In the iframe, the first bit is 0. In S-frame, the first two bits are 1 and 0. And in the U-frame, the first two bits are 1 and 1. There are also extended forms of I and S-frames. Again, the least significant bit is sent first. This is the extended version of HDLC control fields, wherein this is the 16-bit table, and in extended I frame the first bit is 0, and in extended S frames the first bit is 1 and 0. These are the references from where we studied this PPT and made it. If you need any further information, you can go to these links and browse the data. It is of course free of cost. Thank you.